this is Highlander, the card game, video number one, hopefully in a long line of videos. I just want to go over seven quick things regarding Highlander, the card game specifically, but out of those seven things, first one will be just Highlander in general. But that first topic, what is this? This is about Highlander, the card game specifically, second edition, which a lot of people don't even know exists. And it's been brought to my attention. And second issue on that, Immortals are not all Highlanders. Immortals can come from anywhere in the world. A lot of times I hear people say, oh, he must be a Highlander, he'll come back from the dead. No, it's Highlanders refer to where the Clan MacLeod comes from in the Highlands of Scotland. So the primary characters in the TV series and in the movies are Highlanders. That's where the name comes from. But to be factual regarding Fantasy World, they are immortals. So now we've got that settled. That takes care of item number one. What is this about? Item number two, isn't that a dead card game? No, not dead yet. I am actually one of the Omaha, Nebraska tournament directors, and we actively run tournaments at least once a month here locally. I know that in the home of Highlander, Kansas City, Missouri area, there are tournaments being run as well, and there's an entire forum of people that are running tournaments in various parts of the country. So the game is still around, including a Gen Con championship, which is coming up. But that is pretty much addressing that. Most card games have basically had to adapt, change, or die. And I love what they've done with the Highlander card game. It has evolved. And yes, all card games have issues. Back in the 90s, everybody and their mom was making card games, and many of them have fallen by the wayside. Highlander is still around, and, you know, even the strong ones go down. Look at Legend of the Five Rings. That was a huge game, probably second only to Magic, and it's, for all intents and purposes, dead. If you ask any player who played Legend of the Five Rings for a long time, they will tell you it's dead. It's going to come out in a living card game format, but that's not the same incarnation. It's going to be a whole different environment with the non-collectible thing. So, second topic, isn't that a dead card game? No, it is not. Item number three on the list. What do you mean by second edition? Highlander originally came out in the mid to late 1990s with the first edition, and it was amazing. It introduced a whole new style of gameplay, different from many other card games out at the time. Its innovation, I think, rivals only that of the Decipher Star Wars card game, which did a very good job of mimicking its world and giving you a good feel for how things are supposed to run in that world. So it does a very good job of that. But it's basically a whole new ball game with second edition. With second edition, Highlander has done a lot of different things, from basic deck construction to the various amounts of immortals you can play. And why is this edition better? This edition is better simply because it's slowed the game down. A lot of broken quick combos that used to hurt people in first edition have been slowed down. It takes more cards. You can still do a lot of the same stuff, but it takes more cards and more turns to accomplish the same things that you used to be able to, which does help, you know, newer players survive longer and have a fighting chance. So I definitely like that. Item number four I want to cover, where can I buy these cards? Right now, it currently has taken on the living card game format, similar. They're going with a versus deck. Basically, the versus deck is, you pay a flat fee, you get two starter decks basically in a box, and it comes with enough cards to play two immortals right out of the box, so to speak. They're not overpowering, you're not going to be truly competitive at that point, but it gives you what you need to start off with that immortal. So I like the format they've done. They are in the process of rolling out buy-in or initial product that new players can get into. And that is something that is being worked on, as far as I understand, from the company. But the primary source for getting cards right now is BakersHighlandersCCGStore.com. And I've added a link to this video so you can go there if you would like to browse his inventory. Also, you can buy cards on eBay. He does have a lot of those versus decks or entire Immortal sets on sale there. He does quite a few fire sales. It's Baker's store, but he sells through eBay as well. You know, if you want to buy a cheap weapon of choice with all the cards for that said weapon, or if you want to buy an Immortal, you can buy the full set, basically getting all the cards for that Immortal all in one shot. You know, so you don't have to be buying box after box after box. I have opposed the living card game or non-collectible version of card games for a while. It seems to work well with Highlander, though. I do miss the trading and that nature of the card games, but now that I'm older, I have a family, I have kids, it's a lot more difficult to be buying box after box, opening those, organizing them, so on and so forth. Now I can just buy a set, I know I have all the cards for that Immortal, and I can dive right into playing. And also, if you have some cards and you would like to trade, you know, maybe you buy a versus deck, you want one Immortal but not the other one, you can go on to the forums and trade Immortals or cards with other players that are out there right now. Item number 5. Is there a community online? Yes, there is. This is going to be the first place. I plan on making successive videos here on YouTube that will go over basic strategies, different tips, tricks, reviews of certain Immortals and weapons. So hopefully I plan to make this a long-running series to help support the game I love. We also have a message board that's been up for several years. It's HighlanderTCG.proboards.com. If you need me to repeat that, HighlanderTCG.proboards.com. And that is a community that's been around for a few years. Every question, rules question that you could think of has been asked on there. A lot of times I'll do a search for a question that we have in the middle of a tournament. Boom, it pulls up the thread, and you can get a ruling exactly from the design team, which gives you an instant answer. So it does an excellent job of serving that purpose, at least. Otherwise, they do tournament reports there. They let you know of upcoming events that are coming up throughout the country. It helps you find local players. You can even talk about other Highlander stuff, like maybe the new movie that's in the works, things of that nature. It's definitely a good community. Item number 6, strategy basics for new players. And this is geared more towards those who did play Highlander back in the 90s in the first edition version to help kind of give you a feel of what you're looking at here. I'm just going to go over some of the basic major tactics, which aren't too different from first edition. The first one is the burn tactic, which basically forces you to burn cards off the top of your deck. When you run out of the deck, you lose 5 ability, so on and so forth. So that's a primary tactic of quite a few decks out there. And an easy stop for that is the Crusade helmet, or Crusader helmet. You can buy those really dirt cheap on Baker's website. I believe they're like a nickel a piece. And it would definitely help stave that off. Then you have disarm tactics where they try to take your sword away so you can't block or attack. And a quick fix for that is another 5-cent card, extra weapon. So even though these tactics are very debilitating, there is meta to stop those that's very cheap and affordable. So even for a new player, it's not insurmountable. A lot of it does come down to luck of the draw, but you have a 15-card head size. So, I mean, it's like any other card game. The next one is cheese, or direct damage, where your opponent just plays a card, it does direct damage to you. Another cheap buy are the police cards that prevent damage from events. Those you can also get through Baker's site. And the last tactic is to make attacks unblockable and undodgeable. And I do have to tell you that I've ended up a foot shorter from several of those types of decks where they make the attack or headshot unblockable or undodgeable or both. Easy fix for that. Another nickel card, the Alertness Edge, which that will help you be able to block or dodge depending on the type of alertness you get. And that's another cheap way to get through that. Sometimes I just don't draw them. Other times, you know, I don't see the card the whole game. But that's just my awesome luck. Basic grid cards, get plenty of those. Basic attacks, basic blocks. They have a new deck building system, which I'll go over in the next video. But it relies on having the right gems for the right stats for the right immortal that you're playing. And in a nutshell, you want to have lots of different sets of these attacks and blocks, so it'll help you in deck construction. So that's item number 6. Item number 7, last one. Creating a playgroup or an environment for growth. Yes, maybe you're interested in Highlander, you love the movies, you're a fan of the TV series, you want to get this started, get this going. First rule, don't be a jerk. You know, gamers in general tend to be more reclusive people. We like to get into groups where we can make friends, build a camaraderie, and, you know, hopefully work together towards a goal. Which brings us to the next topic within creating a playgroup, which is competitiveness. It's great to be competitive. It's awesome. Definitely come out to regional events, come out to Gen Con, be competitive, you know, do your thing. But when you're playing with your local playgroup, especially if you're the one starting that playgroup, keep the competitiveness down, you know, help the newbies get going. You know, focus on trying out different mechanics, trying out new strategies, new decks, new immortals. But take your competitiveness to regional events or national events where you can really shine there. Just because, you know, once the Gen Con is over or whatever and World Championships is over, you still have to go back and live with the people that you play with. So don't be jerks to them. They're going to help support your game. Help each other out. You know, drop a $20 investment, go to Baker's website, you can get a ton of cheap commons and uncommons. The way Highlander is designed, I've seen people win with decks of just commons and uncommons. It's the only game I know of where you can get a lucky headshot in, which is a common card, and an upper attack, which is a common card, and if your opponent just doesn't have the defense in their hand or they can't exert for it, they lose their head, game over. You don't have that in any other card game. And start cheap, work your way up, or just get a few cards, make a small investment. You know, you could drop $20, get enough for 2 or 3 decks, start teaching it to your friends. If they're into it, then they'll see value in it and they'll start investing. But that's all I have for today, keeping this video short. But a preview of the next video, we're going to go over basic deck construction, including the, gem format. We're also going to cover the Gen Con tournaments that we have lined up, which are going to be awesome. And we're going to go over a featured immortal, which is Duncan MacLeod, just to go over that basic character, which seems to be a very favorite of a lot of players for obvious reasons. So that's pretty much it, and have a good one.